you just said to me as well, you're playing Ash, can't believe it, before 10 o'clock, 20 that years old.
So, 20 years old is insane, but I like the connection with Ash Wednesday. I think that's brilliant. This shows why it's a good thing you're doing this programme, Danielle. You know, you're putting your head down, you're getting these ideas into action and on air. That's what we need you for.
Well, thank you very much. It was their first official single back in February of 1994. Can you cast your mind back to what you were doing in that year?
Back in my youth.
All our youth.
When I was back in primary school. Yes, I can.
Do you care to share it?
Well, XFM was struggling to get a licence back in those days, and Ash were one of our bands that we felt very strongly about, partly because they were managed by a guy who was very involved with XFM at that point. In fact, Ash's manager at the time was one of the two people who originally set up XFM. His name is Tav. He's still going strong, he's still in management, still managing amazing bands. And the guy who started XFM was a guy called Sammy Jacob, and at one point they ran a pirate radio station that didn't have the name XFM.
Right.
And there was something about it being on top of a tower block, the receiver or the transmitter was on top of a tower block. And I seem to remember Tav telling me this story about him running up towards wherever the radio station was based, and Sammy running down the stairs, and there's smoke coming from the roof, and something about Sammy saying, quick, get out now before the police and the fire brigade arrive. We've got to move. And I always think that's an amazing story. So I think that was in around 1989 or something like that. And then a few years later, Tav got into record promotion and then management and discovered this teenage band from Northern Ireland, Ash, and we were right behind him and thought, yeah, this band's great, and we played them on the radio, and this was kind of one of the reasons why we felt that XFM should exist, so that we could play records like this on the radio in the daytime and the nighttime.
Wow.
And that's exactly what we were doing, but it took us 5 years to convince the authorities that be, that give out radio licences, that we were right, and finally they agreed.
And now, 20 years later, we're playing the re-recorded version of it, so it's almost full circle, isn't it?
That's amazing. Happy birthday, Ash.
Absolutely. Well, John Kennedy, that is why you are my favourite, and you'll be on air with Exposure in just 20 minutes time. XFM. As I was just talking about with John Kennedy, Jack Names the Planets is 20 years old this week. It was their first single release, really, and they're doing a free download of a re-recorded version of it this Wednesday, which is today. Obviously, you can get that on our website, xfm.co.uk. Let's play it. Let me know what you think at XFM. New Order on XFM. I heard about the re-recorded version of Jack Names the Planets. Thumbs up from the studio this end. What do you reckon? Tom loved it. And Alex too, is just saying, so good to hear that. A bit heavier, really liking it. So thank you very much for all of those. Now, John Kennedy is on the way next with Exposure. Make sure you join him for that.